Hey guys, so you may have noticed there was an ad at the beginning of this video, which means that I am officially monetized here on YouTube. I mean, like, I'm about to start getting I'm already getting paid to do the things I love to do. I mean, like, who doesn't want to make money? Yeah, so in this video, I am going to be sharing with you how it happened, how long it took me to get monetized. I'm going to be sharing with you my analytics, through the Google AdSense process, how long it took to get approved, the things required of you, as well as share with you how you can actually speed up the entire process so you can start making money off all your videos. So if that sounds like something you are interested in, then definitely keep on watching. So hey love, welcome back to my channel. If this is your first time of stopping by, you are definitely most welcome. Please don't make it your last by subscribing to my channel down below. Also turn on the post notification so you can get notified when I drop similar content like this one. If you are a returning subscriber, thank you so much for coming back to watch my videos. Lest I forget, if you don't know my name is Adeshola Mi and I'm a YouTuber based in Lagos. I'm also a mathematician amongst many other things that I do. Okay, let's jump right into why we are here. All right, before we go into the whole YouTube monetization process, I'm going to be sharing with you things that are required of you as a YouTuber in order to make money. If you are not familiar with the whole YouTube terms and conditions and everything, I think it is about time you go through it, especially if you want to start making money off your videos. But here I'm going to break it down to you, so don't worry, don't sweat it on. We're going to be going through all of those things in this video. The first thing we're going to be talking about is the eligibility requirement. YouTube expects you to have at least 1,000 subscribers, like 1,000 people subscribing to your channel. First of all, the second thing is that you need to have 4,000 watch hours. 4,000 watch hours. And when we talk about 4,000 watch hours, YouTube is not saying people has to watch your video 4,000 times. It basically means people has to watch your video for 4,000 hours, which is also the same thing as 240,000 minutes. 240,000 minutes. So I'm going to break it down to you again. If you are a kind of person, or if you're a YouTuber that posts 10-minute videos, say for example you want to be posting nothing less than 10 minutes videos. Sometimes it could be like 11 minutes, but let's just leave it on an average of 10. That means you need to post about 24,000 videos to get 240,000 hours. But there's also a twist to that, which we are still going to dive into much later. But for now, you need to know that you are expected to have 240,000 watch minutes, public watch minutes on your video, excluding unlisted video, excluding private videos. Everything that has to count towards the monetization needs to be public. Hey guys, so I'm currently editing this video now and I realized I didn't mention the fact that your 4,000 hours is only valid for the last 12 months, which means that anything you upload outside of the 12 months, it's not going to be counted towards your monetization process. Basically, what it means is that YouTube start counting for the last 12 months. Now that we are in August, if you are looking at getting monetized in September 2021, you need to look back from last year, September 1st, 2020. That way, it's a whole calendar year rather than counting from when you started filming or when you started creating content for YouTube. I hope you understand that. In my next video, I'm going to try as much as possible to explain this particular requirement even more. I'm sorry I skipped it, so let's continue. Videos people can see and, you know, people can watch. That is it. The third one is that you need to live in a country where YouTube partnership is available. I don't think there are countries that YouTube partnership is not available, but you also want to make that research. And you don't need to like do so much research about that. If you know a YouTuber that lives in your country and you see how you've been watching his or her videos and there's probably ads on her videos, then you should know that, okay, then YouTube partnership is available in my country. The next thing you need to do before you can get monetized is to have a link AdSense account. I'm going to be sharing with you how I linked my AdSense account in this video as well, but you want to have a linked AdSense account. Now, if you already have an existing AdSense account, this is not going to be like so much trouble for you. Like, it's going to be pretty simple, pretty easy, and everything is going to be right in place. Now, the fifth one is that you want to make sure you do not have any active community strikes on your videos. You want to make sure to follow all YouTube community guidelines. When we talk about strikes, YouTube is basically talking about copyright music or copyright in general. You don't want to copy someone else's video, upload it to YouTube and claim it to make money. It doesn't work that way. So everything you post on YouTube has to be like created by you, basically created by you from start to finish. If I am taking my time to create this video, upload it on YouTube, and then someone downloads the video and re-upload it on video, you're definitely going to like get a copyright strike on your video. So stuff like copyrighted music and all of those things. To avoid copyright claims, basically, when it comes to music, there are several apps, there are several websites you can get copyright-free music. I did upload one, I think last month. I'm going to leave the link up here so you guys can check out for like free copyright music on your YouTube. Okay, so once you look through the eligibility requirements and you've passed that milestone, because guys, it's actually not easy to get 1,000 subscribers, and even if that is pretty much easy, it takes a whole lot of time to get 4,000 watch hours. So now let's go behind the scene of how it happened to me, because again, that is why we are here. So to get started with the whole monetization process, again, like I said, you need 1,000 subscribers and 4,000 watch hours. Let me explain the 4,000 watch hours in details. Now, 4,000 hours means 240,000 minute watch minute. So basically, if you upload a video of 10 minutes on your channel and if 100 people watches that video, you get like 100 times 10 minutes, which is 1,000 minutes. But obviously, people can all watch your video from the beginning to the end. To be honest, I've had videos that performed really well. I've had people watch my videos, a 16-minute video, and people watch it for like 10 minutes and then they just stop watching. I've had 16-minute video being watched for like 3 minutes, 2 minutes, 1 minute. So even if you have 1,000 views on your channel, if you have like a lower retention rate, it's going to affect your watch time and your watch hours, basically everything that has to do with all of those watch hour, watch minute, watch time and everything. So to avoid that, you want to make sure that you create engaging content on YouTube, content that people can watch till the very end, or content that would actually get people stuck on watching your channel, content that can make people binge watch your channel and all of those stuff. Because if you upload a video and 20,000 people watches that one video, but they all watched for 1 minute, that is your average retention rate is 1 minute, that means you're going to be having a total of 20,000 watch minutes and not 200,000 watch minutes because you posted a video of 10 minutes. So you need to make sure that you are posting engaging videos. Well, of course, if you are extremely lucky and YouTube picks up that video, say for example, that one video that got you 20,000 views got to about maybe 100,000 and people watched for like 5 minutes, that's 5 minutes times 100,000 people, which is 500,000 minutes, and then you are expected to have 240,000 minutes, if that makes sense to you. So you need to be like always calculative and make your YouTube studio your best friend. I think, I don't know if that makes sense to your ears, but when you take your time to go through all of these things, then you're going to understand that okay, your watch hour and your watch minute is actually very much important than the number of people watching your views. I would rather have people watch my videos all through, have 10 people watch a 10-minute video to about say like 8 minutes, and have like 80 minutes of people watching my videos, people's time, you get, rather than have 100 people watching and then watching for 1 minute, if that makes sense to you. So that is it when it comes to like the YouTube watch time, watch hour and everything. All right, so with me, I have a book here that I'm trying to look through so I can give you the exact date. On the 3rd of August this year, I crossed that milestone. That is, I had 120 subscribers and I had 4,089 watch hours. Guys, I was really excited and I couldn't actually wait to like, you know, jump on the process and start getting money, because I needed that money. And I've been on YouTube for over a year. My first video was uploaded on the 25th of March. I didn't remember to write that down, but I remember it was 25th, sometimes in March during COVID last year.
Before we proceed, I would like us to know that I did not read the manual. I'll be better, but I'll never be somebody else.
25th of March. That was when I uploaded my first video. So when I was eligible on the August 3rd this year, I applied on the 4th of August this year as well. And you know, it was pretty smooth. I just basically had to like do some things on my dashboard and then I got approved. So the next stage was to like do my Google AdSense. I applied for Google AdSense on the 4th of August. The same day I applied was the same day I kind of like applied for my Google AdSense. I applied for my Google AdSense and then it was reviewed. It took like 24 hours. To be very honest, I think with my monetization, I was pretty lucky because everything got approved almost immediately when I applied. It literally took YouTube like 48 hours to approve my channel for monetization. So again, for Google AdSense, I applied on the 4th of August and it got reviewed the same day and I got approved on the 5th of August. That was literally less than 24 hours because I applied around 12 p.m. in the afternoon on the 4th of August. And then by the time I woke up August 5th, I received a mail from Google AdSense saying it has been approved, blah, 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 blah. So after that, you need to like apply for the YouTube partnership, get reviewed and all stuff. That is like the major part of it and the most important part of the whole monetization process. Okay, so I applied for that August 5th after Google AdSense approved my details. Like I had to like send them my, what's it called, my passport. I think I sent my passport and my legal name, not the additional misspellings, my surname, my first name and my last name, just the way it appeared on my international passport and all of my other documents. So that was when Google AdSense approved it. So with YouTube partnership, I applied on the 5th of August and I got approved on the 6th of August. Guys, I've watched a whole lot of videos. I don't think I've watched monetization videos this year, but as a last year when I got started into YouTube, I watched a whole lot of videos and I used to hear people talk about, oh, I got monetized 1 month after, 10 weeks after, and I was kind of like expecting something similar to that, like okay, maybe YouTube is going to take forever to approve my channel. But guys, I literally got approved the second day. I applied 5th, got approved 6th. So it happened that I was eligible on the 3rd. I applied on the 4th, applied for Google AdSense on the 4th, I got approved on the 5th, applied for YouTube partnership on the 5th and got approved on the 6th. Guys, it was just a very smooth journey. And I think the things that helped me with my channel was that I kind of like avoided all of those community strikes. There was no copyright. I only had one copyright claim on my video because if you look down my channel, I started with like reaction videos and also I had one copyright claim and I didn't really want to remove it. I didn't stress about it. I just left it. But before then I had like 3 copyright claims, which I kind of like sent a mail to YouTube or to the owner of the music. And you know, we went to like a whole dispute review kind of thing, which took about 30 days, guys, 30 days. So for 30 days, people were not watching that particular video, you get. So you want to avoid all of those kind of strikes. Also, I used to have this shooting during this NSAS. I made some videos that, you know, there were gunshots, blood and all of those things, so I made sure I took those videos down from my channel so that it would be easy for YouTube to monetize my channel, to approve my channel in good time. Aside from that, I don't think I have like any other contradicting things to what YouTube allows on this platform. Do you get what I'm trying to say? So you want to make sure you avoid, I think the most important thing is to avoid all those community guidelines. Don't post nude pictures, don't post nude videos, don't smoke on YouTube, don't do drugs on YouTube, don't do any other thing. I'm not supposed to be talking about this because for a reason, I think this is gonna affect my CPM or my heartbeat. But anyway, I'm just trying to make you guys understand how this whole thing works. It's not like you're gonna start your channel today and then you're gonna get monetized tomorrow. It takes a whole lot of hard work and consistency. You can like be very lucky with YouTube algorithm and then if it favors you, good for you. But I feel like if YouTube algorithm doesn't really favor you in time, you just need to be really consistent and be doing a whole lot of things to get your channel monetized. So after YouTube approved my, you know, they sent me a mail saying, oh, congratulations, additionally you've been approved, blah. That was on the 6th of August. So on the 8th of August, I got an email from Google saying I need to verify my address. Okay, so I think that was when I kind of like uploaded my international passport. So YouTube can verify, as well as Google can verify, that I am a real person. I'm not a robot. I'm not maybe an alien or something. So I had to like impute all of my official documents. That was on the 8th, and I got approved on the 9th. See, I know a friend, there's this friend of mine that is like a software engineer, is into all of this, not like YouTube, but is like what's this thing called? It's like a software kind of person. It codes, so he knows how Google Access as well as other things work. When I sent it to him, like, okay, I sent this yesterday and it got approved. Even before I sent to him, the first day I sent him the old YouTube process something, or maybe the verification, he was telling me that, oh, this is the tough part of it, probably like a week or something. And boom, the following day I received email. Look at what the Lord has done for me. Guys, let's just say I was really lucky, and I hope that if you are watching this video, you are as lucky as I am when you get to your monetization process. All right, so that was everything that kind of like went down behind the scene of me getting monetized. So it was really easy, it was really smooth. And when YouTube sent me that email, the first thing I said to my sister was that, please go and watch one of my videos, let's see if there are ads on the videos. But unfortunately, there were no ads. I had to like go behind the scene to turn on all of those monetization stuff on my YouTube channel, because YouTube is not going to turn them on automatically for you. You have to go down to your YouTube dashboard to turn on all those monetization and kind of like tweak it to where you want your ads to show, how you want it to show. Do you want it to display on the screen? Do you want it to show as cards, amongst like many other things? So when you go into your YouTube dashboard, you are going to see all of those features when you get accepted into the YouTube partnership program. Okay, so the last thing here to talk about is the PIN, which I would ideally use to receive payment. Unfortunately, I've not received the PIN, but on my dashboard, I can view how much I'm earning and how much I make. I can view the top performing videos on my channel, and I can view which country is my like highest paying country. Like if it's Nigeria, like I'm in right Nigeria, so for now Nigeria is that country that is generating most of my income. I have subscribers from US, from Congo. And the truth about getting monetized on YouTube is that you have access to a whole lot of other things. Before I got monetized, I was not seeing like the top countries that was watching my videos. I was not seeing suggested videos that I can recreate based on what my audience are watching. So if you are looking at getting into monetization, if you are looking at getting into the YouTube partnership program, I would suggest you kind of like stick to the 5 eligibility requirement. There are a whole lot of other requirements, but I want you to like take these 5. I think we have 5 here, and I want you to take them really, really serious. That way it's going to improve how you get monetized and like how long YouTube can kind of approve your monetization application, if that makes sense. So you get the gist and you get the drill. Basically, just stick to those 5 things and make sure you're doing smooth. So if you're watching this video now and you've watched up until this point, I want you to go back to your YouTube dashboard. If you have any copyright claim, do not delete the video. I'm going to be sharing with you maybe later how you can actually dispute a copyright claim, so you can take it up without having to take the video down, or without the owner of the music or the owner of the content making money off the video that you took your time and energy to create. You get what I'm saying, basically? So I'm going to be sharing that video maybe later, not today, not even like tomorrow, but I'm going to create a video like that soonest, because I have been down that lane and guys, I couldn't afford to like let a copyright claim be on my video. Okay, so we are going to be ending this video here. If you found this video helpful so far, please make sure you subscribe to my channel. If you are not yet subscribed, subscribe now, like right now, bro. Right now, say subscribe to my channel. Also turn on the post notification and leave a comment down in the section box below if there is anything that you know that is kind of like injuring your YouTube partnership application being approved, or if there's anything you want to add to this video, if there's anything I have probably missed. All right, so we've come to the end of this video. If you find this helpful so far, please don't forget to like this video. Don't forget to share this video among your fellow YouTubers that I've not even monetized, because I am literally going to be sharing with you everything that goes on from now on. In my next video, I'm going to be sharing with you how much I made from a video that got me like 200k views. So if you want to watch that video as well, if you don't want to miss it, make sure you stay tuned to this channel. Thank you very much. Stay safe, stay blessed. I'm going to see my next one.